हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द लेसन दैट इज एयर एंड वाटर। यस विदाउट एयर एंड वाटर लाइफ इज नॉट पॉसिबल। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट इट एंड इन दिस लेसन we discuss before this video air and how air get polluted and how can we save air and how can we protect our environment. And now today, in today's topic, we are going to discuss about water. Water, we cannot live on the earth without water. All we know, life is not possible without water. Water is necessary thing for our life. Water is used for, dear student, in this segment we will see how and what are the uses of water in our daily life. All we know, just for example, water is used for drinking, washing, cleaning, bathing, irrigation, swimming, water transport, putting out fire. Yes student, these are the uses of water that we do in our daily life. And where do we get water from? Means from where we get the water? Different sources of water in village and in cities. So in cities we get water from big tanks. Yes student, in cities we get water from big tanks. It purified and supplied to our homes through underground pipes. All we know about it, by underground pipe we get water in cities. In villages, people dig wells or use hand pumps to get water. But when we talk about the village, the picture is different. In villages we dig well for water and we get the water from hand pumps. Yes student, so these are the sources of water separately in cities and in villages. Forms of water. Yes student, forms of water: solid, that is in ice form, liquid and gas or vapor. Yes student, water is in, when water get cool, it convert into snow or ice, and when it start melting, it converted into liquid form, and when it evaporates, it converted into gas, or you can say water vapor. In nature, water keeps changing its form. In nature, water keeps changing in form, its form. The water in ocean, seas, river, lakes and ponds get heated by sun. It rises from water vapor high in the sky. Water vapor cools down and forms tiny droplets. These tiny drops join to form clouds. Yes student, it is called water cycle. You can see here, these clouds get bigger and fall down as rain. Again, rainwater collects in water bodies. This is the water cycle. Yes, student? First of all, we will see water is in liquid form and facing the sunlight, water get evaporate and it converted into clouds and tiny droplets in the form of clouds because of condensation, and after condensation water vapor converted into water droplets, and these droplets fall on the ground in the form of precipitation or rain. Yes, student, this water vapor gets down towards the earth with the help of rain, or you can say precipitation, and it again moves towards the river, ocean, lakes and ponds, and after that getting the sunlight it evaporates, and after evaporating it convert into gas or vapor, and after cooling it gets change in water droplets, that is called condensation. And after condensation, when clouds get wetted, it starts raining. So this cycle is called water cycle. So my dear student, again rainwater collects in water bodies, you can see here, this is the water cycle. Yes student, it is called the water cycle. So in this lesson we studied about the two things, and remaining part will be discussed in next video. In this lesson we saw how we get water and air, how can we stop pollution, and what is water cycle. So it's all about our today's class, and I hope you are doing your homework properly by preparing your notebook. Prepare your notebook properly and learn it. Dear student, it is very hard time and you have to cooperate with us. It is your responsibility to complete, to learn and to manage yourself according to the situation. So have a good day.